Hey, please subscribe to our channel and give a thumbs up to this video. Now, in this video, we focus on the IGCSE. So this paper is from the CIE Accounting Board. So the year of this examination paper is taken from 2019 October Winter Series. And today, we will put our focus on a topic called non-profit making. So it's all about those organizations, they are not going to make profit, but still we have to do a set of accounting for them. So so let's take a look these questions. Okay, so there are total two questions, part A and part B. So I've put the answer on the right hand side. So this is the answer for part A, and for the lower part in the right hand side is the answer for part B. So let's take a look part A first. So for part A, we have to prepare the subscription account. So before we do that, okay, so let's take a look what are the major elements in the subscription account. So let's take a look the right top corner. So there are both balance bo jiang on left hand side and right hand side, and balance carry, and also balance carry down. Okay, once you finished. So I would like to remind you these two balance bo jiang from August 1. Okay, there are different meanings. For the debit balance, it's a kind of asset. So that means people they own. Okay, owned by us. So that means people they haven't paid. So on the other hand, on the credit side, so this is a kind of liabilities. So this is we owned, the company owned to people. That means the company haven't provided services to these people. So I would like to remind you they are different. Alright, then let's move on to take a look at the question. So it talks about there are 150 members, and any subscription fee would be $50. So right now you can compute the subscription amount. So that would be 7,500. That means okay, you just multiply them. Okay, we just multiply them. So I will put down the formula for you. So for this one, it would be 150 people times $50 each. So that gives you 7,500 in this part. So now let's move on to the balances. Okay, so on August 1, so you may put this down. Okay, so this is, so in this paragraph it talks about the balance bought down. Okay, in this paragraph, so there are outstanding from five members. So these five members, so these they own us. Okay, so these will be our assets. Okay, so this will be our assets. So we have to do the calculation. So this is okay, so that's this one. Okay, so five members times $50 each, so that gives you $250. On the other hand, okay, so there are two members has paid the subscription in advance. So it's when they pay the subscription in advance, this one, so this is a kind of liabilities. So and then we can work out the math. So the math would be very easy. Okay, so for this one, it would be two members times $50. So that's the liabilities. So right now let's move on to this one on 31 July. So this one, it would be about the balance carry down. Okay, because it's the year end. So on the balance carry down, so there are people who paid in advance. So when we call paid in advance, it's a kind of of course, is again, it's a kind of liabilities, right? So for all, you can see that, okay, for all these, okay, we call it liabilities. So for liabilities, so let's look at the right-hand side for the answer. For the liabilities, so this one, this is called the liabilities, right? On the credit balance, okay. So this is called the liabilities. As there are four members who paid in advance, then we can work out the math very easily. So this would be equal to four members times $50 each. So that gives you $200. So right now, okay, of course, after you boost the balance point down here, of course, there is a kind of balance carry down here, okay? Right? Now, yes, this is the balance put down on the credit side. So that means the balance credit, the balance carry down, you will put it here. So right now, okay, after all these figures you have, then you can work out one balance figure. So that is the bank and cash. So this one, we call it balance figure. So this is not provided in the question. This is not provided in the question, okay? So we have to work it out on our own. So how to do that? So let's take a look. So right now we have all these figures, 2550, 7500, and 200. So you will have to add this up, 250 plus 7500 plus 200. And then minus this one, and then minus this one, minus 100, okay? And then minus 100, then we can have it. Then we will have this one called the balance figure, 7850. Okay, I would like to remind you this one, okay? It's a kind of balance figure. Okay, it's not providing the question, we have to get it, okay? And the last, it's the last item of part A. So, that's all for part A, okay? I would like to remind you in the answer, okay, you have to show the balance breakdown, okay, on August 1, like this one, this here. Okay, or let me highlight it for you, okay, for this one. So you have to bring down the balance, so that means you have to do something like this, okay? Good. Now, so let's move on to part, I would like to remind you, this one, no marks for balance carry down, but one mark for the balance breakdown, okay, so remember you have to put this down. Now, let's take a look part B. So for part B, we have to prepare the receipts and payments accounts, okay? Okay, so like this, so you can see on the right bottom corner, you can see the answer for part B will be like this. So before we get started, let's do some marking, okay? So first of all, for here, for the debit side, here, for the debit side, it will be about receipts, okay? On the other hand, for the credit side, it would be about payment. So for all the payment, we have to do it, okay, on the right hand side. For all the receipts, okay, we do it on the left hand side. So we use blue color and green color, okay, to represent receipts and payments respectively. So let's get started. So first of all, you can see, so there is a bank overdraft, 2620. So that is a kind of liability. So we put it here. Okay, so remember for bank overdraft is a kind of liabilities. So that means we owe to the bank. Great. Now, so next, so let's take a look here. Okay, so we have 2620 as the balance breakdown for the receipts and payment account. Now on the other hand, this one, 5% loans from this one is not included in the receipt and payments account, okay? Because this is not in the cash book, okay? So let's mark that down. This one, remember, don't put it as balance brought down. No, okay, this is not for the receipt and payments account. No, okay, don't do it, okay? So that's a kind of trap for you, okay? So remember that. Now, so we will move on to the receipts and payments, okay? So so let's take a look at the first one. The first one is about subscription received from the members. So we can take it from part A. So let's mark it down. So this one is from part A. So from part A, the answer is 7,850. So we will put it here. This 7,580, we will put it here. Then you can get one mark. Okay. Now, next, take a look at the loan interest and the repayment of loan. So first of all, we will take a look what is the amount of loan. So as you can see here, the amount of loan will be 2,000. So right now, then you can see the loan is 2,000. And then you can grab the interest. So they paid 2,100 as total. So you may mark this down. So this one would equal to 2,100 minus 2,000. So then you can have the loan interest as 100. So this one is a little bit difficult, okay? So this is the total repayment. You can work it out, the repayment of loan is 2,000. Then the loan interest will be 100. So as you can see on the right bottom corner. So next, let's move on. The third one. The third one is about received from the members. So then of course, then you can have it here. So this is a loan from interest, that's a receipt. So next, let's take a look at the fourth one. So the fourth one is about some general expenses. Then of course, it's a kind of, you know, a payment. Rated insurance, then keep going, then you put it on the right hand side. Okay, and the sport equipment, then you put it on the credit side. The repairment, of course, you put it on the credit side. So the proceed, next we'll move on to the proceed. The proceed, that means the receive, right? You receive something, so you put it on the left hand side. And this one is the receipt, right? So you put it on the left hand side again. On the last one is the expenses, so you put it on the right hand side. So you can see, starting from starting from the number three items, all these are very, okay, I would say, you just copy, okay, copy and paste on the debit and credit, okay, in responses to receipt and payment. So these are very easy, okay, I would say, these are very easy. Now, let's move on, okay. So right now, okay, you can see here, so there are, okay, expenses accrued and insurance prepaid. So these accounts, they are not relevant, okay, to the cash book, okay. So these are traps, okay. I would like to remind you, these are traps, and these are not irrelevant, okay. These are irrelevant information. So please, okay, don't put that on the account. So right now, okay, after you grab all these, then you can work out the balance carry down, okay. So you add up all these items and minus all these items, okay. So before you finish the account, remember you have to bring down the balance on August 1st. That's this one, so you can have it from here, right? Okay, you can have it from here and put it here. So one mark will be for this one, no mark for the balance carry down. So so that's all for the IGCSE accounting non-profit making section, okay. This paper is taken from the 2019 October session, okay. Please subscribe to my channel and give a thumbs up to this video.